Then your subconscious, because it has got memories of past lives, all the other lives, sometimes it so happens that, especially if you take the example of phobias, we do not know why you are afraid. You have a phobia of claustrophobia or phobia of heights. Phobia and fear, there is a difference between the two. Fear is when you know the reason. Phobia is you are afraid but you do not know why. Phobia of water. Some people will not get into the swimming pool. Will not learn swimming, will not go on. It is usually a past life, and in a past life they have faced death due to drowning or... So that fear, when they see water or something happens, that memory comes back. The fear comes back. So again, if you go to a past life, you can resolve these issues. So many of these phobias, these fears, so, many of these phobias are usually past life. Now this is, you can say, the other twist to the story. So, what we do in hypnosis and hypnotherapy is basically we start off with an issue, which may be a physical issue or which may be an emotional issue or relationship issue. And we try to go to the root cause. The moment you identify the cause of any disease or any issue, you can always treat it. So every person, whatever you are doing, whatever you are behaving like, the seed is usually sown because of some reason, either in your childhood or due to something which has been activated from this. What we all desire, what do we all desire? Eventually, when you have lived your life, you have reached towards the older age of your life. We want basically peace, contentment, happiness. And all these three things are actually within. We look for it outside. So if you are looking in the wrong place, how you will achieve it? So, I come to the next part of the talk, giving you a basic outline. This school which we call, which we have come to actually, I call it a circus. We are all monkeys in the circus, performing. So as long as you are monkey, you will keep facing this. Sometimes up, sometimes down. So instead of being a monkey, you can be godless. Even if you understand this, you will always get pulled into the circus. I will show you a carrot and you will get it. And then you get bitten by a stick, you will realize that you are going to go. So entire life is a carrot and stick. Now what makes you go to the circus? You are born here, you have come here to learn a lesson. Circumstances in life will make you learn the lesson. That is okay. Learn your lesson, but why go through all this stuff? So, we have the physical body and the conscious mind. The conscious mind basically is a friend which feeds your ego. So we come to the next aspect, that is the ego. Now, what exactly is it? Nothing bad. We usually think that he has a very big ego. acceptance of yourself as an element. But the problem with the ego is the one which actually binds you to the outside world. Through the main five senses, the five horses, of which the biggest problem is the taste, books, apart from that smell, touch, all these also hearing. But the taste and the looks, if you really ask yourself, every time we want food which is good taste. And as far as looks are concerned, the entire industry runs on looks. If you were not bothered about looks, half the economy would have collapsed. Everybody wants to look. So the girl dresses up, wears new clothes, spends a lot of time in the parlor. Husband says, "Oh, you're looking very nice, you're so happy." Then she goes to the party. She meets a friend and a friend says, "Honey, you're wearing the same dress you wore at the last party." You're looking nice. Immediately that anger and this thing. We go ahead, another person says, "Honey, you put on a lot of weight." All your appetite gone. You come home, throw your dress, all that money and effort gone. So the ego is something which needs constant gratification. It always needs to be. So if you look at yourself in your daily life, if we consider us, me, I, you want to be the best, the top, nobody better than you, the person everybody should look up, everybody should praise, you must be most powerful, most good looking. Everybody should be the same. And the moment something happens, it is not according to this belief, all those emotions. So the ego is actually an attachment which binds you. So if we come to attachments, in human beings there are three major groups of attachments. First is the most basic, or we call it the area of Brahma, the materialistic attachments. Property, car, clothes, money. With understanding, people do get over this. The second attachment of which is vision, emotion, attachment to your children, to your parents. Bacche ko kuch ho gaya to you are in trouble. Child goes away, you are much more difficult. And the final attachment is the attachment of Shiva, the third eye, the attachment to I, self. We are so afraid of death. We are so afraid of a lot of other problems that can happen to us.
The third is with the Lord, with the God. First is with the material things.
Second is with the emotional attachment. Emotions. And third is with yourself. Attachment with yourself. Yes. I. So the last attachment is with yourself.
So loving myself.
Attached to yourself. The existence that you are. I exist. The moment you can come over from this attachment. And you start thinking that I am no one. The moment you say, "I am no one, all is him," at that time duality merges into singularity. That is what is the essence of meditation. So the moment you are nobody, how is this problem or will that problem? If somebody abuses you, you know what he is abusing him. He will take care. What is there to worry? When you were born on this earth, what did you come with? Nothing. When you go from here, what will you take? Nothing.